Problem number 5. The sides of a square are initially 5 inches in length and increase at a constant rate of 3 inches per second. One corner of the square moves along a line L at a speed of 2 inches per second for 5 seconds. During this time, the square makes one complete revolution about L, revolving at a constant rate and remaining always perpendicular to L. Explain carefully how to compute the volume of the solid generated by the square. Carry out the computation you describe. Now the question is, what is the volume of the solid generated by the square? So first is we're going to draw the square. And if it is drawn to its 2D perspective, it would look like this. And if it is drawn to its 3D perspective, it would look like this one. Now the length is equal to 5 plus 3t is equal to x. The width is also 5 plus 3t is equal to y. And the height is equal to 2t is equal to 2. And now we're going to solve this using the triple integral. Since we're going to use the triple integral, the equation would look like this. Now the first thing that we're going to integrate is with respect to dx. So we will have x evaluate from 0 to 5 plus 3t dy dz is equal to 5 plus 3t dy dz. And then we will have 5y plus 3yt dz from 0 to 2t. 5 times the quantity of 5 plus 3t plus 3t plus the quantity of 5 plus 3t dz from 0 to 5 plus 3t. Now, to integrate with respect to dz, we're going to integrate this by parts. So we'll have 5, and we're going to put the constant 5 and 3t to the left side. So we'll have 5 times the integral of 5 plus 3t dz from 0 to 2t plus 3t times the integral of 5 plus 3t dz from 0 to 2t. And then the integral of this one would be equal to 5 times the quantity of 5z plus 3zt plus 3t times the quantity of 5z plus 3zt evaluate from 0 to 2t. Now if we're going to evaluate this one, it would be equal to 5 times the quantity of 5 times 2t plus 3 times 2t times t plus 3t times the quantity of 5 times 2t plus 3 times 2t times t. Now if we're going to simplify this one, it would give us 5 times the quantity of 10t plus 6t squared plus 3t times the quantity of 10t plus 6t squared. Now we're going to evaluate this one at t is equal to 5. So we will have 5 times the quantity of 10 times 5 plus 6 times 5 squared plus 3 times 5 times the quantity of 10 times 5 plus 6 times 5 squared. Now if we're going to solve this one, it would give us 4,000 cubic units. And that is the final answer for the problem number 5.